am carrying the name and signature of the Minister Delegate at the Presidency of the Republic in charge of defense, Joseph Betty Asamon, indicates that secessionists and terrorists are in Yaounde, living with Anglophones in the areas like Biemasi, Obili, and Tugebe, and who are planning to attack the town on October 1 and 7, 2018. Joseph Betty Asamon, in the document, orders top military personnel to take stringent measures to neutralize any move from whosoever. One noting is that it is not the first time that the government is placing such a surveillance order in Anglophone populated neighborhoods in the country. A similar move last year witnessed massive arrest of many people, of many without identity papers on them. In another development, the President of the National Communication Council, Peter Isokam, will later today grant a press conference at the headquarters of the Council in Yaounde. Focus will be on the electoral campaign coverage that begins tomorrow. The conference starts at 3 p.m. Meantime, an arrest warrant currently weighs over Peter Isokam for not respecting the sentence passed against him in the court case pitting him to Vision Card Television. The warrant has been issued by the President of the Fundi Court of First Instance. The President of the National Communications Council was sentenced to 6 months in prison, substituted with a fine of close to 20 million CFA francs to pay as damages to Vision Card and its proprietor Amugu Bellingham for having declared that the TV channel is gradually becoming Rwanda's Radio Milcoline. Carrying the name and signature of the Minister Delegate at the Presidency of the Republic in charge of defense, Joseph Betty Asamon, indicates that secessionists and terrorists are in Yaounde, living with Anglophones in the areas like Biemasi, Obili, and Tugebe, and who are planning to attack the town on October 1 and 7, 2018. Joseph Betty Asamon, in the document, orders top military personnel to take stringent measures to neutralize any move from whosoever. One noting is that it is not the first time that the government is placing such a surveillance order in Anglophone populated neighborhoods in the country. A similar move last year witnessed massive arrest of many people, of many without identity papers on them. In another development, the President of the National Communication Council, Peter Isokam, will later today grant a press conference at the headquarters of the Council in Yaounde. Focus will be on the electoral campaign coverage that begins tomorrow. The conference starts at 3 p.m. Meantime, an arrest warrant currently weighs over Peter Isokam for not respecting the sentence passed against him in the court case pitting him to Vision Card Television. The warrant has been issued by the President of the Fundi Court of First Instance. The President of the National Communications Council was sentenced to 6 months in prison, substituted with a fine of close to 20 million CFA francs to pay as damages to Vision Card and its proprietor Amugu Bellingham for having declared that the TV channel is gradually becoming Rwanda's Radio Milcoline.